stop in Ottawa. That we'd go to near the station.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there was there were a couple of shops. I admit it for a long time. We went down to Ottawa and
Thompson Street or something.
It's pretty crude by today's standards with the ice hatches and it's one of the few I haven't scrapped or gotten rid of because it's an early effort of mine years ago and it's kind of survived.
Keep it stuck.
Actually right here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And comes out here? Yeah, it comes down here and then loops back when it comes back up.
Okay.
We operated a staging, both ends of the railroad was there, so we're operating like it was separated, but mm-hmm. we stopped the cycle.
Semaphores, yeah.
Tank work, you know, it performs the same function as the prep test.
Yeah.
Well, not very much. He's pretty much enjoying what he's doing up in South Dakota, working for Dakota, Minnesota, and Eastern. That's what he works for, and he loves it, and so
we'll, just to give Jim a flavor, we'll run something, we run a lot of passion trains in the railroad, but, in fact, this is the...
And those are the transcontinental cars,
that's
right?
That's great looking car.
Yeah, it is great. It's a neat thing.
Then the crew just begins to follow signals.
Check out this train that's coming around here.
Okay, we got a red over yellow. The next one, we think we're going to cut us back over the other track. This is what we're supposed to do. This is the the transcontinental cars. This is the third car. It's a New York Central car that came out in the 20th century. If you'll notice, there's a subtle difference in the way the cars are painted. Light gray window band, dark gray window band. That's the Pensy and Central, and they're competitive reference. But the cars were in the gray scheme. The Santa Fe car had a silver roof instead of a black roof.
Until the Super Chief came to being, this was the flagship train, and then the Super Chief became the flagship, although this train still maintained about the same kind of schedule. But it was in this car, this train, like the Super Chief, was an all sleeping car train, with no chair cars on it. So everything was sleeping cars. Okay, then we got a yellow over.
So what do you mean, where they were?
Pardon?
Two nights to kill.
Well, actually, it was.
We got on one coming up here, and it was so awesome.
Oh, that's wonderful.
I mean, you could see the up by Jeff City, the eagles would be flying.
But it is a wonderful. You got a. Now going into Marceline. See, we're going to Marceline now, Denny. Mm-hmm. And we're going on green. When the train hits the track, it's ultimately going to tie up on, it'll go yellow, which tells us we got train length to go before it's clear. And then it goes red and we make a manual shutdown. That's how the station goes.
Listen.
Anyway.
Thank you. we have a grade crossing about where Dennis is staying, and there's a whistle, mm-hmm. there's a post. I was telling Candace, this engine, here's the sophistication. When we use the horn and the bell, which uses air, the compressor senses that usage. And it turns on the air compressors. Yeah. The way this is, the pressure's up, then it kicks it back off again.
This technology we have today is something, isn't it?
One is the bell and two is the horn. Okay. Headlights on, that's zero. That was the only three. You can get a brake squeal if you want to stop and hit button seven. You'll get a brake squeal. And, there's more things you can do. They're bringing back some empty meat cars right there in the block. Some empty cars going to go to meat packing until.
Mm-hmm.
I had a guy built that for himself and he decided he didn't want it, so he sold it to me. I was happy to get it. You got a whistle post coming up there. You're coming up on it. So just hit the post, hit the one button. Now, QSI, they build a delay in the horn button. I don't know why they do that.
Jim, maybe it takes the whole thing about 3 years ago?
Yeah.
Like 3 years ago.
Yeah. Here's a copy for you.
Oh, thank you.
Two videos I did to New Delhi and FLP over in Washington.
Oh, I was going to say, the big old scale guy. Yeah, Pence guy.
Been torn down since.
I've been to his railroad. We operated on it. Before he tore it down.
Scraped.
Yeah. Yeah, he's very meticulous on the mechanic. Thank you.
Well, I hope so.
I think so.
I think he's a pretty good
one. And they got another bus. The dog came in, but they
had to go back to school in. And so now I've been 6 years for a good person. Surrounded diesel, should be very good. But if the diesel is as good as steam from here, they don't have some special steam for it. It is. We've seen it.
I've gotten kind of used to the two button is the. This is the number three, which is just a short copy. I've got kind of used to the 2-3 combination. I think I'd like it, but it's not bad. And I didn't put a wipe on this, it's just got that program thing that uses numbers to get off the CD value. And it's good, it's not perfect, but it's good enough for me. And all this stuff I've got is on a speed curve 8, which means it's cut the top speed down by 30%. The steam engine is more noticeable than the rest of them.
You guys ever talk to Rick McClellan? Huh? Are you going back tomorrow or
no?
You going back tonight?
Saturday.
Well, I talked to Rick McClellan over at Dave Atkins' session in December, and he said he was going to be home. He wants to come and look at the building when he's home tomorrow. Okay? And he probably should be around. I said that you were coming up, and he said that he couldn't, he wouldn't, he'd be at work today, but he could be really home tomorrow. Let me write down a memo while you guys are sitting here.
So you don't think, you know, you usually don't see anything run this fast. Transfer is run pretty slow by the nature.
10 o'clock is about the throttle, is a pretty good. Pretty good speed, 10 temperature.
That's about what it is. So.
Yeah, that's pretty good speed for.
This track is elevated a little bit in the rear ballast. That's kind of really concerning.
Do you like the sound level?
Because it's one of us, it just gets too busy. Yeah, especially when you have several parked next to each other, it just gets to be right noise almost.
We got some very specific rules about use of the train signals, and we try to make the queries, on the page two here, basically, it talks about headlights are to be this point front and rear day and night. Ring the engine bell under any of the following certain conditions. Those are conditions, but the last thing says, the unnecessary use of the bell is prohibited.
Yeah.
So, well, didn't mean to go there, did you? I wasn't checking where you were.